What's up, Fort Worth fam? It's the Kid Big Boss Fable, Fort Worth Fabian. I'm back with a reaction video. Of course, I told you guys I was back with more Queen. So I'm doing a lot of random Queen stuff, man. And mark my words, man, I'm going to upload like a madman now. Mark my words. I know I've said this a lot, and I do upload a lot, but now I'm just pissed, man. I'm mad. I'm angry that I haven't been uploading as frequently as I should. And, you know, I'm going to take time to really just go on a wave, man. I really just want to take this channel to the next level. I know that there's times where I was hitting an extreme amount of growth, and I know I've seen the growth die down. And I think it's because of the content I've been posting, to be honest. When I was doing Queen and just other stuff, my channel was growing at a rapid rate. I'll tell you that right now. Queen and Elvis and like Angelina Jordan and Ali Bata, Morissette of Mom, my Queen was growing crazy. Righteous Brothers, it slowed down. And I'm not trying to halt it, man. So like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Fort Worth Fabian. We're on the road to 10K. We should have been at 10K already, but, you know, I ain't halting anytime soon. So just, you know, show love. And with that being said, I went live earlier today. If y'all joined the live, I talked about Queen. I had just seen the Bohemian Rhapsody film yesterday. I was a fan of it, but of course I have my critiques. And we talked about that in the live stream. I appreciate everybody that joined this morning. You should be able to find that upload soon enough as it processes and uploads. It was a 2-hour live stream, so it's going to take a while to upload on YouTube for YouTube to process it to my channel. But we're doing top 10 Queen songs written by Roger Taylor. A reaction to that right now, man. It dropped on the Wet Feet channel 569, Wet Feet 569. You know, we're going to get to this music. With that being said, like, comment, subscribe, man. Hit the notification bell. I love Roger, man. I love Roger Taylor. So let's get it. Top 10 Queen songs written by Roger. Modern Times Rock and Roll. I didn't know he wrote that song, In the Lap of the Gods. That's news to me. Why didn't you guys tell me that in the comment section? What? I think you guys may have told me that, man. But that's news to me. I didn't know he wrote that. Don't Lose Your Head is number 8.
Don't lose your head.
So I can kind of see the real punk vibe, the punk rockish type vibe that people were saying. I had a problem with in the movie how they depicted or they showed him as such a, they depicted Roger as such a wild card. Like, you know, he was the bad boy, punk rock guy. There's nothing to expect from him. Like, not nothing to expect, but you wouldn't know what to expect. He seemed like a real hothead in the movie, and I haven't seen that come across as his persona in interviews. He just seemed like a real humble dude, but maybe in his younger years, that's exactly what he was like. I haven't heard this Don't Lose Your Head song, though. More of that jazz. This is definitely pure rock. Bashir Heart Attack, I had reacted to a performance of this one. I think it was from the 70s. But yeah, I definitely didn't know he had the connection with this song as well. The way that you talk, don't remember nothing. the Invisible Man. Don't get it twisted. Roger had a mean pen. He had a mean pen game. And if you still don't know what that means, when somebody says you have a mean pen game, that means you got a mean writing game. That means you got a mean pen. Your writing is up to par. He had a pen. You know what I mean? The dude could write music. Like Roger, you know, and especially how they mentioned that his vocal obviously had different vocal capabilities, but he was able to hit higher notes, you know, in Bohemian Rhapsody, where it's like Galileo. Supposedly that was Roger, because he could hit that note, you know what I'm saying? So the dude is very musically inclined, don't get it twisted, you know what I mean? Like, and I'm in love with my car, I still rock with that song. And it's funny because you see the perception it got when I watched the movie Bohemian Rhapsody. Supposedly, not certain if this is factual. You know, the record executive exec or the owner of the label wasn't a fan of pushing that as a pushing Bohemian Rhapsody as a single, but wanted to push, you know, I'm in love with my car, Roger Taylor song. This one's great, A Kind of Magic. Alright, so this is the top 10 songs written by Roger Taylor. Not necessarily the only 10 songs he wrote. So there could be a whole plethora of songs that he's actually penned. And, you know, they're not even on this list. I guess these are just the top 10 fan favorites. You know, but what is this list really coming from? I'm not too sure. This could just be a fan favorite list. Because, obviously, this list isn't certified. But, yeah, a lot of these songs on here are big songs. You know what I mean? In the swiftness of time. He said he's got a feel for his automobile. So I can see why they may have had issues. I don't know. I mean, I don't. It's a cool song, right? But it's funny because I'm relating this comment to a part of the movie that I saw where it was they were breaking down the lyrics to his song and they said it was kind of like a derogatory line, but he made it sound, you know, he made it really smooth sounding in association with a part of a vehicle, a car. So he had a little type of play on words with that, and they were just like, what do you really mean by that? You know what I mean? But it was funny to me, man, especially in the movie, man. I'm so happy that I saw the movie because that's like, of course, I can get a closer feel of Queen through their interviews and their actual live documented performances, etc., versus a reenactment, right? But I just felt really more drawn into the story, man. So if y'all have any more tidbits, like interviews, things that I should check out, comment section below. And the number one song written by Roger Taylor is... My Boy Did Radio Gaga. I feel like I'm just forgetting these tidbits but today this feels like news to me. But I did not know he wrote Radio Gaga. Wow, that kind of blows my mind a little bit. It seems like a very, for some reason, I felt like that was a very Freddie written song. I don't know. I felt like that was more his style. All we hear is Radio Gaga, Radio Gaga. Dang, that'd blow my mind, man. There you have it. These are the top 10 Queen songs written by Roger Taylor, man. Like, comment, subscribe, hit the notification bell, follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Fort Worth Fabian. I really enjoyed this content. Obviously, this is fan-made, you know what I mean? But I enjoyed this right here, man. This is dope. With that being said, man, what are your top 10 favorite Queen songs written by Roger? Put them in the comment section below, man. Be sure to tune into my live streams. If you're feeling generous, be sure to donate to the channel as well. You can do that through the live stream, through a super chat, or you can go down to the description of this video and donate to my PayPal. $5 goes a long way, you know what I mean? So with that being said, man, I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.